Out in the country, expansion is also on the minds of cattle producers like Bruce Alford, operator of a multi-generational stocker operation in Arkansas. Stocker operations play a key role in the beef supply chain, and they depend on a steady supply of calves for their livelihood. As backgrounders, they work to transition calves between weaning and placement in the feed yard. Cattleman to Cattleman reporter Russell Nemitz shows us how one operation in Arkansas helps its animals efficiently pack on the pounds.
Bruce Alford Farms is a cattle backgrounding operation located in the southwest corner of Arkansas. Owner Bruce Alford continues the tradition started by his father back in the 1950s.
He started here in 1956 and had to start on little scale, small scales, and since then we started our own operations and added to his and just made it bigger and bigger. We feed a handful of cattle. We buy the 2 and 3 weights and put them on wheat and gain them on grass as much as possible and sell them to feed yards.
Stocker operators like Bruce rely on forage in combination with grains to increase a calf's weight by several hundred pounds and to build up immunity to diseases before it enters a feedlot. Over the years, Bruce has found that one of the keys to healthy animals is getting the cattle off to a good start once they arrive at his place.
The main thing is to get them to eating and drinking. So far, it's worked real good. Now, we do need to make some changes yet. You don't never quit changing, but it's worked good, and then we'll put them in traps for a short period of time, 30 days, and try to put them out in bigger pastures after that. The ones that perform well will gain well. In a short period of time, there's nothing to get 2 pounds a day gains out of them in the first 2 weeks. And one that is challenged would be different. Is they're not going to gain as good. The health problem's going to be worse. It's just totally different.
Diagnosing and treating sick animals is essential in the stocker business. Bruce says there's one thing cow-calf operators could do to help make life a little easier for the people in the cattle industry farther down the production pipeline.
Get a good vaccination program and put it in them. Go ahead on. Put it in them and go on. It'd help the respiratory problems and the whole shebang. It'd help us a whole bunch.
An ample supply of good quality pasture throughout the grazing season is the goal of every stocker operator. But when the grass is down, Bruce gets creative to make sure his cattle are gaining. That means turning to some non-traditional ways to feed the cattle, like peanuts.
The pellets, a lot of them come from Alabama and Georgia and everywhere else. And they are peanut hull pellets because normally they're cheaper and they work good for us. And cottonseed hulls, we use cottonseed hulls. It's syrup, put a little syrup in it, get a smell on it. Most of the cattle we buy don't know what feed is, don't know what water troughs are or anything else. So you kind of got to train them and tow them a little bit.
Bruce buys and sells cattle throughout the year. Although there are many options for marketing cattle, Bruce prefers to sell his animals directly to feed yards and order buyers.
I'm probably different than most people. When I'm ready to sell, I'm ready to sell. And I get it done. I don't have to wait 2 weeks to put them on the video and get them on the television, get them sold. And sometimes that's bad and sometimes it's good. But usually when I feel it's right to sell, I'm selling.
Despite the challenges that he faces on a day-to-day basis, Bruce is confident in the long-term outlook for the beef industry.
The market right now is unbelievable. We're in ground that none of us have ever seen before that's in the cattle business. The prices are just unbelievable. And I do think that the market will be fine for a while. It's no doubt with prices that we have today that they will rebuild herds if they got the marsh to do it with. It's a totally different deal today than it was just a few years ago. You're looking at a world market today. We're getting so many people. I think the beef industry, I think it's all going to be good for us for several years to come.
And hopefully, Bruce's outlook for a bright future in the cattle business proves to be correct. Reporting from Louisville, Arkansas, I'm Russell Nemitz for NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.
To join cattlemen and women like Bruce Alford and help support NCBA's efforts to improve the operating environment for the entire beef industry, just visit the website beefusa.org or call 1-866-USA-BEEF.